So today we're talking about intermolecular forces. What does this word intermolecular mean? You want to think about like an interstate? What does that mean? A road that goes between states. So intermolecular, if I have molecules, so covalently bonded together atoms, intermolecular forces are the forces that are between. So in between those molecules. Let's go ahead and define that. Intermolecular forces are forces or interactions. Forces are interactions that are between the molecules. And these are really important because these intermolecular forces dictate or tell or force and dictate physical properties. So what are some examples of physical properties? Boiling point, for instance, is a physical property. So that temperature when liquid goes to a gas. Melting point, that's a physical property. The temperature where a solid goes to a liquid. What about viscosity? The thickness of a liquid or of a gas in some ways, but how tightly packed those are. And that is all dictated by these interactions, the things that go on between the molecules. And every kind of intermolecular force has something to do So all of these intermolecular forces have to do with charge. So a positive or a negative charge. What's true about opposites? What's true about these opposite charges? Do they attract or they repel each other? They do attract. Okay. This is called a Coulombic attraction. So, this is just a big fancy science word that means opposites attract. Coulombic attraction. So it's this positive and negative attraction. Have you guys ever played with those really strong magnets? And when you get them stuck together, are they easy to pull apart? No, it takes a lot of muscle to pull them apart. You almost have to really try. That's part of this Coulombic attraction, is that when you have a really large positive and a large negative, you're gonna get a large attraction. This is called an ionic bond. So that's what's happening with our ionic bonds. We have a cation and an anion, and it's a large positive and a large negative. It makes a large attraction. Okay. But I thought we were talking about covalent bonds in this unit, right? We are. And in a covalent bond, we are going to have partial positives and partial negatives, and we call that polarity. So in the covalent bond, we have a partial positive, so a little positive, and a partial negative, and that's going to equal a smaller attraction. It's kind of like a flirt. Okay. This ionic bond makes a permanent stuck together, sort of. But the partial positive and the partial negative makes a smaller attraction. Okay. That is between molecules. So we have a symbol for that, and that looks like this, partial positive and a partial negative. So I know it looks like a little crazy S, but this little crazy S stands for partial. When you see that, you'll read it partial positive and partial negative. Okay. Alright, we see this in the covalent in groups of covalent molecules. There are three kinds of these attractions, these forces that we're going to talk about. The first one is called dipole to dipole attraction. Dipole to dipole attraction. Anybody know what a dipole is? Nope. Okay. A dipole, this pole part, like the pole on the north pole, the south pole, the pole of the planet, is permanent polarity. So we have a permanent polar to a permanent polar. This is the strongest of these intermolecular forces. So, if we are doing with dipole to dipole attraction, dipole is a permanent polarity. What kind of bond are we going to be dealing with in these dipole-to-dipole attractions? We talked about them yesterday. So, this occurs or happens or is. This is between polar covalent molecules. So, between polar covalent molecules. Because these polar covalent molecules have a dipole. They have that permanent partial positive, partial negative. So let's think about what we saw yesterday. Go back to our notes from yesterday. And we talked about these polar bonds, polar covalent bonds. We had this carbon monoxide as an example. Okay? So we will go ahead and use this as our example today, since that's what we had yesterday. Right, so carbon, we had two. Might not be the best example in the world, but it'll work. Okay. And yesterday we saw, we were using some numbers, and maybe we didn't make the connection on what those numbers really meant, but we're going to try to make that connection today. Oxygen was 3.5, carbon was 2.5. What does that even mean? That means that the oxygen wants to pull all those electrons, a whole one difference, electronegative difference of one. In English, right? In English, it means the electrons like the oxygen way more. So they're going to come and they're going to fly around the oxygen atom a lot more than they fly around the carbon atom. If I have a whole bunch of electrons over here flying around this oxygen atom, what charge is going to be over here flying around the oxygen atom? What charge are electrons? negative. Right, so we're going to have a partial negative over here. If the electrons are flying around the oxygen, what charge does that leave the carbon with? Positive, a partial positive. Okay, so this is a permanent polarity because there is such a big difference in the electronegativities of these atoms. Alright, now what does that mean for between polar covalent molecules? This is one molecule. If I have another one, then I have a partial positive on the carbon again, and it's going to be attracted to the partial negative of the oxygen. And we're going to line up in kind of a pattern. We might have another molecule of this gas, and we're going to have its partial positive is going to be attracted to the partial negative. And so they kind of line up and interact in that way. Give me a thumbs up if that makes sense. Okay. All right, now we have a special case of dipole-to-dipole attraction. So we're going to connect them. I'm going to write that on here. Special case. I'm going to turn my notebook even. Special case. So in the special case of dipole-dipole attraction, it's called a hydrogen bond. So everything that we set up here is the same for the hydrogen bond, and we're going to add something. We're going to say it always includes one of these. Fluorine, oxygen, and nitrogen. Okay. So let's look at an example of something that has oxygen and hydrogen in it. So you guys know this one. What is that? H2O. It's water, right? So we know we've kind of drawn this molecule several times, and we know we have its little unshared pairs on the other side forcing that molecule to be bent. Oxygen is a lot more electronegative than hydrogen. So these electrons are going to be carrying on all around the oxygen and leaving the hydrogen alone. What does that do to this molecule? Creates a strong permanent dipole. So we have a partial negative because we have all these negative electrons all flying around, and a partial positive over here. This is huge for all of the characteristics of water, because then what you're going to get is you're going to have the water lining up in such a way that the positives and the negatives are close to each other, because the positives and the negatives attract. So partial positive, attraction. Partial negative, there's an attraction. So everything about these intermolecular forces is this attraction between negative and positive. So both of these, dipole-dipole interaction and hydrogen bond, both include polar molecules. There's another one that includes non-polar molecules. So let's talk about London dispersion forces. Okay. These are still going to have to do with positives and negatives, but these are within non-polar molecules, or between. wait a second. If it's nonpolar, it doesn't have a dipole. So how does that even work? Well, let's take an example. If we have oxygen, we know that oxygen, we've drawn oxygen gas before, right? It's the same element. It has the same electronegativity. The electrons are, they both want the electrons the same amount. But momentarily, you might have more electrons over here than over here. So you would have a very faint, momentary partial negative and partial positive. So let's make sure I make it really clear in our notes. This is a momentary dipole. Using vocab words to learn vocab words. Let's make sure we understand that. Momentarily, so just for a second, more electrons are on one atom so then there's still an attraction between positive and negative, so it makes the molecules kind of sticky, but just for a moment. So even though these are the same, just for a moment, they might have a dipole. All right, give me a thumbs up if that makes sense. Any thumbs? Okay, we got some thumbs. All right, so then you want to go answer those questions and then work on your CK12.